Boy, oh boy, I am so excited to show you this. The scientists behind this new research paper reached out to me, and I got to say, I am speechless. Look at this. What you are seeing is not reality. This is a computer simulation. I mean, what? But that is nothing compared to what I found out about this work. It improves on what I think is one of the best papers ever written. Wavelet turbulence. You see, a low-resolution simulation can be computed quickly, but a high-resolution, really detailed one can take forever. So, wavelet turbulence was a way of taking a coarse simulation quickly, and then recreating it with this breathtaking quality. One of the best papers ever written, I think. Yes, I keep saying that. It also won a technical Oscar award, but it had many limitations. For instance, it simulated the smoke or water within a fixed box of cells. Outside the box, nothing happens. So you can make the box huge to cover a large scene, but the memory and compute costs explode, making it extremely inefficient. So if you have a huge area, grids are suddenly not too appealing. Now, particle-based techniques solve this because these are particles after all, and they can travel wherever they please. They are not confined to a grid. Fantastic! Okay, so, are we done here? Well, not quite. You see, particles are also inefficient in large scales to be able to compute pressure, density, surface tension, and all the goodies you need for a proper simulation. These particles need to ask their neighbors for some information. For instance, to know how dense the fluid is around them, each particle has to search for all nearby particles within a certain radius. They must repeat this neighbor search every time step. It is the same with us. If you have a couple neighbors, not a problem. Just ask for their signature for a petition, not a problem, right? Just pop in there, two houses, and we are done. However, now, fellow scholars, imagine that you have billions and billions of neighbors. That is, of course, impossible, right? Now, believe it or not, computer graphics researchers are beyond amazing, and they solved this problem too by building a city hall in the middle of the neighborhood. This is the grid. Welcome back, little grid! So, instead of asking every neighbor one by one, all neighbors, that is, particles, just send their signatures to the city hall, that is, the grid, and the city hall does one big calculation for everyone. These billions of particles, instead of interacting with each other, they interact with the central government. Now, unlike real government centers, this is actually really efficient. And then, it sends the results back to each house. This we call grid-to-particle transfer. And the city hall technique is called FLIP, fluid implicit particle. And it is a hybrid method, a marriage of particles and grids. Okay, so what is the problem? Why do we need this new technique? Well, FLIP cannot easily combine air and water interaction, so no spray particles for us. It is possible, but not easy. Also, cinematic simulations need billions of particles and huge grids. This is still too costly. So, this new technique promises the impossible. High-quality simulations with water spray particles, all the goodies that I'm yearning for. But quickly. I don't believe any of it. So now, hold on to your papers, fellow scholars, and let's have a look. Oh my goodness, do you see how crisp this is? This is so good. I am getting goosebumps here. Wow. With this incredible detail, yes, you can get your spray particles, but that's nothing, man. You can even simulate a huge asteroid impact, a dam break scene, whatever you wish. Goodness, is this reality? Am I dreaming? How is this even possible? Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Dr. Caro Zsolnai-Fehér. Dr. Caro. Well, it does three things really well to accomplish that. First, previous techniques were able to do adaptive particles. More particles where the real action happens, and fewer where there is not much going on. That is, more computation for particles wherever needed, and that is excellent. This one was written by Ryoichi Ando, and when I visited them a few years ago, he did not come to my talk, because he was busy with this paper. I am very sad. But You know what, sir? You are officially forgiven. This work is just too good and way more important than my stupid talk. And he's been up to amazing works ever since. And look, he is unaffiliated. This is usually when you get a nice little offer from Nvidia, but maybe Jensen doesn't know about him yet. And I kinda wanna do an episode on most of these papers. Loving it. Okay, but all this was adaptive particles only. We still need to combine it with adaptive grids. And yes, one, the new research work finally uses adaptive grids and adaptive particles. Finally! This means we only spend computing where the action is, like putting streetlights only where people actually walk, instead of lighting up the entire street. Two, it uses a phase field to naturally separate air and water. No more manually tracing the shoreline. It's like having a smart drone that automatically draws the border between land and sea every frame, so you always know where the splash ends and the air begins. And three, it has a fast adaptive Poisson solver that keeps the pressure computation from eating all the runtime. Yum, yum, yum. Think of it as a super efficient city hall clerk who processes everyone's paperwork in parallel, instead of letting the line go around the block. Oh man, we are back talking about the government again, goodness. So, an absolutely brilliant piece of research, and once again, it is breaking my heart because almost nobody is talking about it. Nobody else does that I know of. These papers are like endangered species. I'm trying to save them. So, before we look at how long we have to wait for such a simulation and how close or not close it can get to reality in the toughest test, please like, subscribe, and leave a really kind comment to help these endangered species and to help you get more videos like this in the future. So, it runs so fast that even billion particle, yes, billion particle, cinematic resolution simulations finish on a single workstation in minutes per frame. So, something that was previously close to impossible is now possible within just a few hours. What a time to be alive! Now, not even this technique is perfect. Its main limitation is that it still targets offline simulation, not real time. And in cases, it ignores very small scale effects like surface tension. But the results are still so real, you can compare them to a real photo and... I can't believe it. Maybe not even tell the difference. That is how advanced current research technology is. And nobody is talking about it. Crazy! Once again, a huge thank you to the scientists reaching out about this paper. I would have missed it myself, I am sure. And source code for not everything, but the data structure is also available. Man, I can't believe it. They finally nailed it. Thank you. And if this is what we can do today on a single computer, on the CPU, no GPU yet, phew, yes, goodness. Imagine what's coming two more papers down the line. Super fast, fully simulated storms with spray particles everywhere at film quality could be just around the corner. Wavelet turbulence was one of the best papers ever written. Yes, I said it again. And this one is maybe even better. No AI needed, just human brilliance. I am speechless. And I got to say, I can't stop playing with OpenAI's OpenGPT model through Lambda GPU Cloud. And, as you see, I am doing very useful things with it. For science. Yes, this is actual speed. I can't believe that I can have more than 100 billion parameters running super, super fast here. Many of you fellow scholars are using it, and if you don't, make sure to check it out. It costs only a couple dollars per hour. Insanity! You can rent an NVIDIA GPU through lambda.ai/papers or click the link in the video description.